Live from his luxury penthouse apartment in London's glittering East End, Dean Lerner, club owner, entrepreneur, and publisher of high-class gentlemen's magazines, invites you to join him for an exclusive man-to-man.
Welcome to Man. My name is Dean Lerner, that's Dean Lerner, and I hope we all learn something tonight. Don't worry, there's no pressure to laugh, it's just meant to be dry. And I say learn because tonight we're about to spend the evening in the company of a genius, and my special guest is pretty bright too. Only joking. We're both geniuses. But this E's VIP visitor is one of the world's most renowned psychics, and he has acted as my personal spiritual guru for the past 20 years. Indeed, before I met him, I thought that astral projection was diarrhea. So you can picture the embarrassing scene when he first asked me to attempt it. But since that unfortunate afternoon, he has led me to new heights of positivity and kindness. At his prompting, I've increased my already considerable charitable endeavours. I recently gave a terminally ill child a home karaoke kit worth over £200. Even though, under the circumstances, I might have been justified in simply lending it to him. He is indisputably one of the most positive, generous-spirited men I know, and I'm truly privileged to call him my friend. Please welcome the extraordinary Amir Chanan.
Hello, Dean. How are you?
I'm good. Thank you.
No, don't answer me yet, because first of all, I would like to psychically energize the members of your audience here and all the people at home so that they stay focused, stay positive, and more importantly, stay to the end.
Okay? I second that.
Okay, so which camera are we on? Hang on, I will sense it psychically. That one. No, hold on. That one. Nope. Hold on. That one. Good. Is that... stay there. OK, come closer. Is my face filling the whole screen?
Yes.
Good, keep it there. Hello, Britain. My name is Amir Chanan, master of the psychic arts. Tonight, we're going to explore the inner cosmos of our minds. I'm going to show you things you never knew about yourselves. I am going to wrap you up in the cotton wool of my mind, wipe away the dirty bits, and touch you all over with my positive energy. What you're about to see tonight will amaze you beyond your wildest dreams. Picture your wildest dream. It's pretty wild, yes? Well, take the wildest dream you have ever had, add it to the wildest night out you have ever spent, and the wildest animal you have seen in a zoo, dress them all up in the wildest clothes you have ever spent a wild amount of money on, and then drop them all in a bin marked tame, because they are nothing compared to the amazing wildness of the amazing wild thing you are about to see. Tonight, on this show, you will witness real-life telekinetic extrasensory perceptive telepathic energizive psychokinesis, or key bending. Now, Dean and I are going to have a chat. We need you at home to send us your positive energies. So say with me, I will keep watching. Even if I have never made it through a whole episode of Man to Man before, I will keep watching. Good, great, over to you, Dean.
Thank you. Thank you very much. And Amir has recorded more messages of positivity which will play in throughout the show as the pace and interest inevitably slackens.
Bondi, be positive.
I am being positive. Most people will not make it to the end of the show. That's just a statistical fact. And you know what? Fuck 'em.
Keep going!
When did you first realise you could bend keys?
I was about 6 years old. I was lying in my bed. I was ill. And all of a sudden, I heard a knocking coming from the window. I was terrified. I got up, I went over to the window, I pulled back the curtain, and I saw a huge finger pointing at me from outside. And after a moment or two, it spoke to me, saying, "Fear not, Amir. I am the finger of Orion, and I bring tidings from the mighty hand of Rastaban. I have traveled through space and time to touch you, for I touched the caveman, and he knew fire. I touched Newton, and he knew gravity. And now I am touching you, and you will know how to bend keys by rubbing them lightly between thumb and forefinger. Yale, deadlocks, luggage keys, all of these will be yours for the bending. But this is a mighty power, Amir, and you must wield it responsibly." That's what it said.
It's quite a specific power to have been granted, isn't it? just keys.
Yes. Who knows, maybe if it had been another finger, or maybe a cosmic thumb, or perhaps the whole hand, which is apparently what happened to Billy Joel when he wrote Uptown Girl. You know, maybe I would have been able to move mountains or turn the seas red with blood. But bending keys is a level of power that I am comfortable with. And if it does go too far, it's nothing that can't be taken care of by a good locksmith.
Sure. But you also managed to tap into the psychic potential of others, didn't you?
That's right. All of us have psychic potential, and I love opening up other people's channels.
Well, we've got a clip of you doing just that. This is when you were on my old show, Dino's After Dark.
Oh, yes.
But before we see it, a brief caveat. It was recorded many moons ago, and since then, attitudes have changed. I didn't see you there. Come in and welcome to the party. I was distracted by the amazing psychic skills of Mr. Amir Chanan. Take it away, Amir.
Thank you, Dean. Hi, I am Amir Chanan, and I am joined here tonight with...
Kerry.
Kerry, that is a wonderful name. That's a beautiful name, Kerry, and I'm reading your mind, and my answer is, I'm busy tonight and I don't pack that kind of equipment.
Come join in, love. There we go.
Okay, now... Kerry, I want you to look for a moment into my eyes, okay? Look into Amir's big, beautiful eyes and know that I am here for you, okay? It is just you, me, and your mind. I am going to penetrate your mind in a good way. You know, it is a little-known fact that human beings use only 10% of their minds. Tonight, I am going to help Kerry use 11%.
Well, that's 11% more than usual.
Dean?
What? She knows she's not bright. Come on.
Rude. Okay, now I want you to focus on one part of my body.
Aye, aye. Here we go.
Dean, don't be dirty.
Oh, come on. I'm just being playful. Am I dirty? Don't answer.
Anyway, have you got that part of my body in your mind?
Oh.
I want you to raise that part of my body. I want you to move it of your own accord using only your own latent psychic abilities. Okay, here we go. I'm going to focus and push everything down. Raise. 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 Now I can feel a little tingling. Something is happening. I don't know if you can see, but my right hand... is raising towards the ceiling. I'm really trying to keep it low. This is very powerful psychic strength. Give her a round of applause. That is amazing. It's unbelievable. Absolutely unbelievable.
Well done. That's amazing. Well done, love. Sit down, Kerry. You might want to rest your mind after that. That was a hell of a workout, wasn't it? Very well. Lovely girl. Thank you. Thank you. And after that historic appearance, we became firm friends. You were a regular guest at Dean Towers, and I took you on as my own psychic advisor. You were always bang on the money, weren't you, Amir? I mean, when I wanted to fuse a carvery with a disco to create the bistro tech... you said it wouldn't work. And you were right. People generally don't want a pre-lunch lap dance. But you also gave me a lot of confidence, didn't you? You gave me the confidence to launch my own aftershave range, Midnight Spray, which was one of the more acrid scents on the market. But then again, I like an aftershave with a bit of bite. Yeah, it was a real love or hate it smell. You gave me the confidence to learn how to read. Up until that point, I was the only publisher in the book business who couldn't read. Which wasn't the hindrance you'd imagine it would be. I found it actually is best to judge a book by its cover. In short, you didn't need to convince me of your abilities, but others still doubted you, didn't they?
That's right. Unfortunately, when you are successful, you are a good psychic, you run a successful nudie bar. Unfortunately, people are always knocking you.
There will always be knockers. And ironically enough, it's the knockers I get the flak for. If you're successful, you are controversial. And that's what happened to you, wasn't it? You were punished for your genius.
That's right. Not very long after that show went out, I was abducted. I was taken to a secret government laboratory and I was tested. I was humiliated. Every kind of implement known to man found a home in my ass. Each week, I had to give fresh ass samples to different scientists. And do you know what? Not one record or document about my ass has been made available to the public. You go to Parliament, you ask your MP about what happened with Amir's ass back in 79, and he'll look the other way. Those cowardly bastards came in the night, scraped me senseless, and left like ninjas. And for what? Because what can you tell from an ass sample anyway?
Fiber intake.
I tell you something, Dean. Having my ass dismantled in such a fashion only made me a stronger person.
And that's what your new DVD is about, isn't it? It's about taking time out to love yourself.
That's right. It is called Bath Buddies with Amir Chanan, and it really is about helping people learn to relax no matter how depressed they are.
Okay. Well, let's take a dip with this clip.
Hello, I am Amir Chanan. And thank you for joining me in my bath. You know, bath time is often somewhere we go to hide away from the world. How many times have you run a bath and thought, will this be my last one? Well, today let Amir be your bath buddy and I will teach you to love bath time again. Breathe in those happy smells. Feel the softness of the bubbles on your skin. It's good, yes? Now, take your trunks off. Hey, come on, take them off. I need all your channels open. There, mine are off too. There is nothing to be ashamed of. You have a beautiful body. No, don't cry. You do. See how the bubbles make all your skin warm, wet, and shiny? Look how your flesh swishes and swirls in the water like moonlit coral. You are beautiful. No, really, you are. You are. Well, he's lying. You are. Close your eyes. I'm going to touch you with my mind. Feel my psychic energy soaking your unhappy body, soaping all that misery away. You feel light as a feather. You are floating. Feel my fingers darting all over your body like little fishes. Now, slowly, very slowly, bring your hands down in front of your body. Lower. Lower. That's good. Even lower.
Thank you.
And after this break, Amir is very kindly going to take any psychic queries you may have. Calls are only £1 a minute, and all proceeds go to the Dean Lerner Dare to Dream Foundation for age and glamour models. So stay right where you are, unless you're currently in peril. Welcome back to Man with Dean Lerner.
Don't go away!
I'm joined by the world-renowned psychic, Amir Chanan. Now, we've been inundated with calls throughout the break asking for Amir's supersensory counsel. So, let's roll it through. Satu, can you connect our first caller?
We have Sandra from Ipswich.
Why does it matter where she's phoning from? I don't care what dead-end town she lives in. Sandra, sweetheart, you're through to Amir.
Hello, Amir.
Hello, Sandra. What is your question?
I was wondering who the most famous person you've ever advised was.
Ooh, I think it probably have to be Margaret Thatcher. And she was great because she was such a good listener and whatever I said she took on board, although I have to say I made a bit of a mistake with the whole Falklands thing. Because, I didn't realise they were near Argentina. I thought they were in the Channel. You know, I actually thought it was where they made Bergerac, which is why I said defend them with all we've got.
Who have we got next?
Line two. The caller's name is Susan.
Hello, Susan. What's your question?
I'm 38 stone and I can't leave the house.
Well, that's more of a statement than a question, love. Next.
No. I want to take this one, Dean, because this sounds like a very sad story.
It's hardly a story. She's given us a unit of measurement. Admittedly, it's a large unit of measurement, but it doesn't make a tale.
Listen, I know a lot about this because when I was younger, I was convicted and imprisoned myself for comfort feeding small animals to death. Because I know for a fact that when someone is unhappy, they will tend to overeat.
Yeah, which ironically means no one will love you. Can we get a picture of Amir's video up? There we go. Okay. Does that answer your question, Susan?
Not really. I want to know what I could do to lose weight.
Nothing, I wouldn't have thought. You're too far gone. But if you stay on the line... if you stay on the line, love, I can recommend a good builder who could widen your doors. And if not, he's got access to a crane. Who's next?
Next caller, Mark from Leeds.
Hi, Mark.
Hi, Amir. Can you tell me, do you believe in God?
Ooh, that is a tough question.
Yeah.
I would say that knowing all I know and having learned all that I have learned, it is all nonsense. There is no God. There is no afterlife. We are all just organisms controlled by a giant cosmic salamander who has planted tiny metallic water boatmen in our brains to spy on our minds.
You heard it here first. I'll tell you what I believe in, Mark, is karma. I'll give you an example. I once had a very special lady friend who was giving me jip. She wouldn't sign a prenup. She wanted me to be faithful. And to cap it all, I found out she was having an affair with Gary Bushell. I don't know what's upset me more, her infidelity or her lack of good taste. Anyway, not long after I discovered that news, she was found gunned down outside her parents' flat. The culprits were never found. Despite my best efforts, I moved on. I had to. But I couldn't help think that there's some kind of cosmic justice at work there. So just bear that in mind, Satu. What goes around comes around.
OK, Dean, I've had just about enough. You have been in a bad mood all evening. I tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to get you, Satu, and me in a bath after this show. And you know what, Dean? Do you know what I'm going to do to make you happy? I am going to bend a key.
Sweet.
OK? Now, I need a neutral key. Satu, do you have a key?
I have this.
Ladies and gentlemen, give Satu a round of applause. Thank you, Satu. Come over here. Thank you. If you'd like to just stand here. Now, let's just have a little bit of quiet, please, from the ladies and gentlemen at home and here. Bend. Bend. send for Amir. Amir wants you to bend, so why don't you? Bend, you fucking piece. it has not worked, as you can see. I have a suspicion, Satu, that you, in front of all these people here, have brought me a key made of wood. Do you deny this? Don't deny me, I am all over your mind. Are you or are you not in the pay of Dr. Eric Wedigan of the Bremen Institute of Plasma Physics? Right, just to explain to you people at home, Dr. Eric Wedigan of the Bremen Institute of Plasma Physics is my psychic nemesis. And he thinks it's haha big joke to send honey traps like Satu here in an effort to debunk me. How much can a man take? Okay, Dean, I have been called a liar. I have been called a trickster. I have been called a viper of the mind. I have been called the bastard son of a big fibbing bitch. At school, they called me shit eater and dick splash. And I don't even know what dick splash means. Okay, I have had enough. You, Satu, and this whole show are assholes. Keep positive. You're an asshole, and this is an asshole. And in fact, you are an asshole too. All of you at home, you are all assholes. Everyone in this country, you are all assholes. You are all assholes. Okay, you are. You're an asshole.
Are we still on for our bath?
Yes, we're still on for a bath.
Well, all that remains for me to do is to thank once again my super guest, Amir Chanan.
Asshole!
There he was. For talking to me, man to man, and to thank you very much for watching. Thank you very much. And we'll play out now with this final goodwill message from Amir.
I'm sorry, Dean.
Yeah, it doesn't fix the show, though, does it?
Drink from my river by Amir Chanan. The sun is so yellow, the sky is so blue, the trees are so green, but what color are you? It does not matter what color you are. Just drink from my river and you will go far. You will go far. Oh, you will go far. Just drink from my river and you will go far. Oh, you will go far. Oh, you will go far. Come see the color of my shooting star. Oh, you will go far. Oh, you will go far. Just drink from my river and you will go a long way out of your lounge, out of your house, down the road, on a bus, off the bus, up to another cosmos and back, e.g. miles and miles and miles, i.e. far. Thank you very much. God bless. I am Amir Chanan, and you are wonderful.